book that I wrote, of all the words that we spoke, yet only with our eyes. Now is the time to choose. Somebody wins and some lose. I can see through your disguise. Lay it down, hope for something better. Looking at the clouds, the slither in the weather. You can't keep this up. The lines are just too.
Guys, welcome back to my channel. We are live here today with the second match of day one of the semi-finals of the Indian FPP Revolution League Season 2. We had the first match at Erangel, and we saw Team RF coming out with that chicken dinner. And match number two here, guys, is at Miramar. So stay tuned for some PUBG Mobile action. Here are the list of teams, guys. Just as the plane takes off, we will get to the plane path in a second. We have Team HOD, Team ANC. We saw a good game from them earlier on today. Team ROTN on slot number 3. Team Hydra getting the fourth player in for the second game. Hydra Krunal coming in. Team TB on slot number 5. We have Team Envy with VD and Salva OP CE on slot 7. We have Team RF, winners of match 1. On slot number 8, we have WIP on slot number 9, we have Thanos on slot number 10, Team Envy on slot number 11, DP on 12, Team Mist on 14, Team ZE40 on 16, Team GG on 17, and Team God on 18. Let's head over now and take a look at this plane path, guys. Alright, so it looks like we have a very east plane path that is going straight over Los Leones. It also goes over Minas Generales, how do you say that? El Azahar, the Junkyard, and also Tierra Bronca. Alright, looks like the teams have begun to make their way, and we'll start from the south and try to catch most of this action. Team Mist here, trying to veer away as southwest as possible. They look like they are going to be heading towards Chumacera, or perhaps even further down south after they pick up a vehicle. Right next to them is Team Envy, and I think this could result in an early engagement at Miramar. Now, we know Miramar is like it's a more time-consuming map. It requires a lot more patience, in my opinion, and it'll be fun to see how this works out. But Team Envy have managed to pick up a vehicle and will go safely away from Team Mist. Little bit to the north is Team CRNG, also in a vehicle. GG Maniac is actually still on his way down, and he should make it in no time. So they also pick up their vehicle and look to make their way into the zone that they wanted to go. Over here at Picado, we have Team Thanos and Team Hydra, two big name teams at Picado, and we can anticipate an early encounter here as well, guys. So let's wait for that. let's head over now to the graveyard where we have team WIB pretty much all alone, and they look okay now. They should be able to pick up some good loot and get set for the rest of this game. Team DP here at San Martin and Hacienda del Patron. We have Team God up against more members, up against us, Team ZE40. So three teams in this little space between Hacienda del Patron and San Martin. Team ANC not far away either, a little bit split up, further north of Hacienda del Patron. M4C for Snipe all the way north up at Water Treatment Plant. So it'll be fun to see how these teams come together. I'm sure there will be an early engagement, as it looks like DP has taken some fight. It looks like a couple of players of Team DP have already been eliminated. They're down to two players. It's just Goku and Fadek, I think I've got that right. Who are they up against? Are they up against Team God or are they up against Team ZE40? Well, Team ZE40 don't have any kills yet, so I'm going to assume that it is actually Team God who managed to pick up those kills. And yes, it is Team God. I'm going to confirm for you guys in a second if it was which player it was. And it was God Nemesis. He was in the chat earlier. Well played to him, picking up those two kills, early kills against Team DP. Shots here, God Nemesis with that M416 spray without a scope, not able to do much damage or get a knock for now. He looks alright. Let's head over now to some other teams and see if there is some action. Let's head over to the north at Cruz de Vale. Team ROTN here at Cruz de Vale. They look all right. They don't have anyone around them for now. CRNG Demon, laggy frames AF. Oh man, I don't know what to do. It looks all right for now is what I would assume, but I don't know how much more I can do to fix that, guys. I'm really sorry. Thanks, Demon, for letting me know. I'm gonna try to do something in settings to fix it, and let's hope it works. Do let me know though in the chat if it's getting better. Team HOD, I don't think I saw them in match one, number one, but they are here at Campo Militar, right next to winners of game number one, Team RF, and in between them, it looks like are three members of Team TB, heading in a car. Getting some shots here at Team TB in their car as they're frantically looking around to see where these shots are coming from. Not doing much damage to them, but I'm sure that car is taking a little bit of damage, endangering a full squad wipe, and we know how bad that can feel. Alright, I've tried to do something else on the stream. I hope it gets better. Too much laggy frames. Too laggy. Just give it a minute, guys, and see if it gets better and let me know. Let's head back to the action, where it looks like I saw a knock on the map, and it looks like TJ from Team TB has been knocked. He is in cover for now. The smokes have come out, and thought I saw Team Envy in that kill feed, but it's possible that someone from Team RF actually managed to secure this knock. But no worries for Team TB for now, because they should be able to get that revive going, and it should be okay. So the zone is now closing in, guys, and it looks like it's centered around El Pozo and Picado, Chumacera, all part of this next zone. Team Mist at the southern tip at Valle del Mar, possibly looking to get a stronger position as the zone closes in. Team DP here having lost a couple of players early on, so they're definitely at a man disadvantage. And it's going to take something special to see them come out of this one and pick up something that's worth anything. Carrie Gujju, shout out please. Yo, big shout out to Carrie Gujju. Carrie Gujju plays for D2K and he's an OP player. If you guys haven't seen him, please go. DP Goku in a death trap, what looks like. That buggy was seconds from exploding. Was it a buggy? No, it was in fact this this pickup truck that we see in Miramar. Goku and the last member of Team BP very, very low on HP here, able to get out of that line of fire. I think it was Team CRNG and GG that were doing that. So they're getting away there. Looks like Team Thanos here getting a couple of knocks on Hydrites over at Picado. Let's go check it out. And Dexter once again finds himself as the last player of Team Thanos. But Hydra was a little bit too much for them. Kunal with that final kill on Thanos. Dexter. Team Thanos has been eliminated, guys. I will confirm. And Team Hydra now bring up their team kill count to 4. Alright, I think the stream is looking better. I will let you guys in chat confirm that if the lagginess has improved. And if it has, then great. So let's get straight back into the game. We saw Hydra eliminating Team Thanos over at Picado. And Envy here closing in on them as well. I wonder if they're headed straight to Picado. This is going to be interesting. Bionix is on a bike and oops. He gets straight back up on that. May not be such a good idea. If Hydra gets wind, and they do, and out come the shots. Who are these shots at? I don't think it's at Mephisto here. Definitely seeing him. Definitely seeing team number 7 going straight past them. As more shots follow from the rest of his teammates, Salva OP might be in trouble here as Mephisto moving to the right, trying to get an angle on him. He starts to lose HP. But Team 7 make it past without getting knocked. Mephisto here with that stray nade. I don't think he's anywhere there, because I think Salva OP made her a fair bit of distance. And he's in fact on top of this ridge as Mephisto approaches from his left. And Mephisto here has reached the top and gets an easy knock on Salva OP, who was laying prone and looking the wrong direction. He got pushed from both sides, so well played to Team Hydra. But they need to pace themselves here, because Envy can just set up a booby trap for them in case they know that they're going to be pushing. Envy crews here, waiting probably, because they don't have a vehicle that can carry all three of them. Two of the players head straight past, and they look okay for now. Hydra not looking to push the rest of the team members. I think they're quite content with just picking up that one kill for now. They bring up the team kill count to 5 guys. So Hydra team looking very, very strong in this game. God Ares, Team God. Yes, bro. Let's go check out Team God right away. Team God is on slot number 18. Team God here picking up a few early kills as well. They have two kills. It's me, AP, God Nemesis, Theos, and Kronos here as well. Ronnie Gaming, Team WIB, lag stream. I think it's better now, but let me know, guys, if it's still not better. I'm hoping that it's better. Yeah, the stream is better. I can confirm. I hope you guys are enjoying it now. Here are some shots with that. The full Envy lineup as a car explodes, and I think that was the end of ANC Vad. We didn't fully catch that. I think he was in this vehicle. Yes, I believe he was. That is very, very unfortunate when that happens. Envy picking up one kill. They don't look like they want to pursue the rest of the ANC team, and I don't even think the rest of the ANC team is around, so it's quite unfortunate. It's hard for you to get separated from your teammates in Miramar, guys, so you might want to watch out for that. I saw on the kill feed Team WIB in action, so I'm gonna go over there and check it out now for Ronnie Gaming. So Team WIB here at Hacienda del Patron. I think they got a knock. They're down one player. Puru has been eliminated. They don't have any team kills, but I did see them picking up a knock on one of the members of Team HOD, and it looks like they're already back up. So not much damage done. But as Team HOD here make their way into this next zone, they will need to drive past Team WIB and also Team ROTN. So let's see how this works out, guys. Team WIB here not looking in the same direction as them, although Team ROTN isn't too far away from them at all. Let's head over now to team number 18, where they look like they have come across team RF winners from the match number 1 earlier today, as team God here tried to consolidate and figure out how they want to play this one. Monk here with that mini 14. Lachit Karmakar, shout out de do, bro. Hey, big shout out to Lachit. Thanks so much, man, for being on the stream. WIB here. Let's go back to that action. It looks like have come in contact with Team HOD. We saw a knock in the kill feed just a few seconds ago. Yes, and I can confirm that a member of Team HOD has been knocked, but this doesn't look like it's going to convert or translate into a full-fledged fight. We might be better off covering that action between Team RF and Team God. It looks like both teams have exchanged knocks. RF have lost SFX completely, and Team God here looking in a difficult position as they're down to just Kronos and Theos, and the other two players are knocked. Theos is 1 HP. Is this the best thing for him to be doing at this point of time without healing? I don't think so, as Kronos prioritizing that res, and Team RF pushing at the right time and capitalizing on their vulnerability, picking up their first squad wipe of this match. Team RF bring up their team kill count to 3, and that marks the end of Team God. Well played to both teams. Let's head back now to finish up that fight between Team WIB and HOD, where it looks like WIB looking a little bit in trouble side. side has also been knocked. It's going to be down to just Hunter, who manages to get that medikit going. Can he pull something off over here? He gets a knock, gets back in cover. That's well played. As the next player approaches from the top, a second knock from Hunter. And that was a good effort, but Team ROTN finally prevailing in that fight. But a big shout out to WIB Hunter for doing that. He managed to get a couple of knocks from a really difficult position, and he tried to get prone and get that final kill, but it wasn't to be. And Team ROTN proving a little bit too strong, possibly because of the man advantage as well. And they come out on top of that fight. So well played to Team WIB, especially Hunter, for that effort. Haan, Gujju sir, Manasvi Sharma lagging. I am really sorry, Manasvi. I think it's better now though. I know it lags a bit, but it can be a lot worse. So there is hacker in game, God Nemesis Gaming. I am really not sure if anyone's hacking, bro. And if someone is, I think you should talk to the organizers about it. I'm just streaming this match for them. So, I'm going to ask that you refrain from such accusations on my chat. Thanks for that. Carry Gujju. Who? Carry Gujju. Really? Let's check. Alright. And I'm just going to take the stream offline for a second, guys. I'll be back. Just give me 1 second. Alright, we are back. Are we back? We are back. It looks like there's another fight here between Team Envy. Was that an OM shot? I think I saw an OM shot, guys. Let me confirm that for you. I don't see an arm over here, but I think I saw an arm in the kill feed, and I think it was a vampire with that knock on one of the teams around him. It's possible that it could be the rest of team ANC, and here they are. We saw ANC Vad unfortunately losing out in that. He was just driving by, and he just got blasted out of his car. Unfortunately, that was the end of him. Here's the rest of his team: is Daxilicious, M4C4 Snipe, and ANC Milind. On this race, looking comfortable for now. Has to be said, they look all right. They've got they got three cars with them. So in case they need cover in a tough situation, they have that option with them. ZE40 here. All players still intact. Haven't come across anyone yet, so they look okay. Z40 Deoxys here with that VSS. How effective is a VSS on Miramar, guys? Let me know what you guys think. How effective is a VSS in Miramar? Because Miramar is just that kind of a map where you it's more precision. It's less aggressive. I think players tend to play more defensively in Miramar simply because of the way the map is structured. I think the best way to describe these is probably Sandhawk is like a T20 game, Erangel is like a 50 over game, and Miramar is like a test match. It's just something that I think that helps people understand the difference between these three maps. So I'm really not sure if VSS is a good choice for this map. Deadeye AP, bro, someone is hacking. I'm really sorry to hear that, guys. If someone is hacking, that really really sucks. And I would request that you guys reach out to Lord Snow ASAP and let him know. Hydra Zigsaw here, getting into a fight. Let's go check that out. We have got a knock. Zigsaw getting a second knock. It looks like Team Mist might be in a little bit of trouble here. Well, actually, it was not a second knock. It was, in fact, them getting... them losing Mist Falcon completely. Pikachu and Shinder... behind this car, as the smokes come out, they need help. I'm not sure how they can get out of the situation, because Hydra looks like they've got them pinned down. They definitely have a stronger inventory. They have the snipers. They've all got into a couple of cars now. And what's the plan here? Well, it looks like in the midst of this fight, ZE40 Chaos has just casually driven past in his buggy, and both these teams haven't really taken note of that. Well, that's interesting, as Team Mist here, Team Hydra pulling out just to update from that earlier fight. Team Hydra, in fact, pulling out of that fight and trying to make a left flank out of this fight, but Mist here have seen them trying to get shots with that Scar L. It was a good spray, but I don't think he could do enough damage to pick up a knock. As Team Mist here with a good pathway into the zone, they look all right. There's a loot not too far away from them. There's Rezzy getting a knock on VD Soggy. Looks like there's another team over here. It's Team Envy. It's Bionics, who is waiting for the arrival of Team Mist, and he gets knocked as well. It's going to be down to Cruz. Envy Cruz is the last player alive, and he gets finished as well. So Team Mist, while making their way into the zone, able to pick up a nice squad wipe, and Team Envy find themselves out of match number 2. Team Hydra here look like they've been separated. And Envy Vampire with that Orm getting a knock on Kunal. I was right when I was saying that earlier. It looks like one of the members of Team Envy have managed to pick up an Orm, and this could be very, very crucial. We all know how dangerous an Orm can be, and stand by for what looks like another knock. And it looks like he might have missed a headshot. And he gets it the second time around. So Team Hydra here finding themselves in a spot of bother. Two players down. And the fourth player, who's all the way down that hill, in fact, not looking like he's going to get revived. It's Kunal, who's all the way down. Oh, and this is a brave ploy. Zigsaw here going down to get that revive. But he's putting himself at risk for getting could get shots from all sides. Is Hydra Lust here getting eliminated by the team on top, and it's only Mephisto who's left. His best shot is probably to come down and be with his teammates, but the number one problem is going to be Vampire with that Orm over on the other side. As Daxilicious gets a knock and a finish with a mini 14, it might just be a kill stolen. As he continues to spray that smoke, and Hydra Zigsaw taking cover behind the tree. ROT and Shiv here taking down DP, a member of Team DP here with an AKM. Let's go check out this fight. It looks like it's further away from that final zone, and ROT and may have to make up a little bit of ground if they want to get into the zone on time. They may end up spending a little bit of time in the blue zone as well, damaging their health. As Daxilicious gets a knock on Hydra Jigsaw, the action that we were covering earlier. Hydra Jigsaw here in an unfavorable position. Envy Vampire getting a knock on GG Ryan. Oh, I didn't guess that name. But with that Orm, and Vampire proving dangerous with that Orm. Missed Shinder with a Kar 98 shot on CRNG Lancer, as M4 C4 Snipe takes down another player. And Mephisto from Hydra has decided that he's not going to be able to get that revive going in time, as RF Hayato, the last player from team number 8, just manages to make it into the zone as the play zone consumes a player of team ROTN. So this is what the final zone is starting to look like, guys, as the team make their way in. But there's going to be a lot of action here, because the team is kept adjusted. And Daxilicious with that M416 getting a knock on a member of team ROTN. Daxilicious here with M4 C4 Snipe and ANC Milland alongside him. Angeles just out with those smokes. This looks like a very interesting final zone. So let's try to get a sense of which teams have the positional advantage. Team GG here getting into a fight with the Team Mist, and it looks like Team Mist has been overpowered by the lineup that had tier players from Team GG and Team CRNG. That was their first squad wipe of this match. It looks like, guys, they bring up the team kill count to 4, and M4C4 Snipe looks like he got knocked by falling over. That is so unfortunate, as that proved to be the end of ANC Milind, M4C4 Snipe. ANC Milind is the last player alive. I think Daxilicious is going to bleed out in that blue zone, and there's not much that could be done about it. As ANC Milind comes under heavy fire, and he might just lose out, and here comes the blue zone. This is so unfortunate for ANC Milind, but he makes it back in, and he's going to be able to get healed. But where did those shots come from? As another member of Team GG gets knocked, and GG fighting back and getting a knock on a member of Team ROTN as well. Guys, stand by for a quick 10 second break. We will be back in 10 seconds. Alright, and we are back with the live action. Sorry about that break. I hope we haven't missed anything over here. Let's get a sense here. The zone has moved in, and Team ROTN here trying to pick a fight, but they are considerably at a disadvantage. And two stray players. It's the last member of Team RF and the last member of Team ANC still alive on the other side of this road. Let's zone in. Let's zero in on this action, guys, and let's hope that the best team comes out. Kronos Gaming, मेरे को सामने से shots आए जब मैं revive कर रहा था Theos को, सामने वाला था, अब बोल ये hack नहीं है तो क्या है? Alright guys, it's we look into it. I will let Lords know that these were the allegations against Team 8, and let's see what best can be done about it. But for now, let's just go ahead and watch this game. God Nemesis Gaming, don't watch this stream, just leave this. You know what? You're welcome to leave, bro. I'm gonna go ahead and put you on timeout, but this is not my tournament, I'm just streaming, so I hope you guys understand. Let's get back into this game, where it looks like Team RF's last member has been eliminated. ANC Midden down to 1 HP as the zone closes in. Things are not looking good for him, and this is most likely going to be a game that's going to be fought for the chicken dinner between teams ROTN and CRNG, and it looks like Team GG and CRNG have made that final push and have picked up that chicken dinner. So well played to Team GG CRNG for I guess getting positioned well right from the beginning, and making sensible pushes into the final zone. So this is what the final standings look like, guys. Team GG picking up that chicken dinner, getting a total team kill count of 7 with Maniac, Ryuk, Lancer and Rana. In second spot is Team ROTN with Toxic Shiv, Ninja and Amru, who have 6 kills to their name. Totally Shiv here with 4 kills. Well played to Team ROTN. I think positionally it was a bit difficult for them to get out of the position, because they had a team on top, and we all know how difficult that can be positionally. Team ANC finishing on third spot with a total team kill count of 6. Well played to them. Daxilicious with those 3 kills. Well played to these top 3 teams. Let's just go ahead and take a look at the rest of the standings. We'll be right back. Alright guys, thanks so much for being on the stream and for being in the chat. I appreciate all you guys. That was the end of match 2, and we do have match 3 as well, but I'm just going to take a pause and check with the admins of this tournament if anything needs to be done to fix this issue that is being talked about in the chat. And if it gets fixed, then we will be back with the next stream at about 9:30. So look forward to that. Thanks so much for all you guys. I know there's some controversial stuff going on, but I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. And that's all from me for now. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. You can't stop now.